Hello YouTube, this is CobraOfficer999 with a quick reaction to Botdf's Davhey Vanity. Blood on the Dance Floor is one of the worst, if not the absolute worst, bands I have ever sampled in recent years. And at 31 years of age, I have heard some pretty awful musicians, if you can call them that in my day. Most of them in the past 4 years. Why is Blood on the Dance Floor the worst band ever? Let's see. One, they can't sing worth a damn. They sound like freshly made eunuchs. Two, their frontman, Mr. or Miss, can't tell, Vanity, is by all indications an unconvicted pedophile. Blood on the Dance Floor forums are full of underage kids and older teens making accusations to this effect. And enough kids are making these accusations for there to be a strong chance he is in actuality a pedophile. I have linked to the Tumblr blog The Truth About Davhey Vanity in the description below. The face paint 3. The face paint is an obvious ripoff of Kiss. Peter Criss, the drummer, in particular. In short, they have no redeeming qualities whatsoever. If I were their fans, I wouldn't waste any more of my time on these scuzzballs. I would go out and find real music that has an actual quality sound to it. Personally, I don't really care about music these days. In my mind, it is not actually music. I would describe the music scene today as a lake into which the factory that is the music industry has pumped massive amounts of absolute overly homogenized sludge like Blood on the Dance Floor, Bieber, Miley Cyrus, Keisha, and Lil Wayne, just to name a few into. Meanwhile, the gold and silver ore, i.e. the bands and artists who actually have talent, like Tarja, Ghost, Nightwish, and other talent bands of past and present, have sunk to the bottom of the lake and become obscured by the sludge that dominates the scene. This has left us, the music fans, to dive through the sludge in order to dig the ore out of the lake bed. What is actual music? What are the bands who have better quality sound than not only Botdf, but the majority of artists, if you can call them that, that do dominate today's music scene? I don't know. Off the top of my head, I'd have to say Al Yankovic, AC/DC, Megadeth, The Buggles, Metallica, Motorhead, Aerosmith, Persia Turunen, Nightwish, Strawberry Alarm Clock, Bob Dylan, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, The Coasters, Epica, Elvis Presley, Queensryche, Lacuna Coil, Queen, The Beatles, Judas Priest, Ghost BC, Motley Crue, Pink Floyd, Iron Maiden, Guns N' Roses, Rammstein, Bon Jovi, Van Halen, and ZZ Top, or the soundtracks of Jesus Christ Superstar, Les Miserables, Chess the Musical, Top Gun, The Fiddler on the Roof, and the Star Wars movies. Even frickin' Deadmau5 has better quality sound than Botdf and other so-called musicians and bands of the present. I could sit here all night rattling off names of better bands and musicians that I would recommend listening to instead of wasting your time and money on Blood on the Dance Floor or any current musician. Expand your horizons a bit. My God, Davhey should be in jail. Hopefully, whichever police department has jurisdiction over whatever town or city the band is touring next should orchestrate an undercover sting operation to bust Davhey for his pedophilia and put him in jail so no one will ever be subjected to his awful music for quite a long time. Another topic. Why is music today so bad? I would have to say it has to do with several factors. First, the internet itself has proven to be a double-edged sword when it comes to music. This the advent of Napster in 1999 and the possibility of people getting music for free caused a series of lawsuits and events that eventually encouraged music companies who didn't want to lose a cent of their already obscene profits to chase down poor college students and others who might or might not have been able to afford the expensive price of CDs and sue them for copyright infringement. But I would also, but it also encouraged these same companies to seize control of the MP3 business in order to offer cheaper, though still not free, digitized versions of music, of their music albums. Second, the internet also opened the door for new musicians like Bieber and Blood on the Dance Floor, who, though they didn't have the skills of musicians or of prior generations like the Beatles, who actually took the time to develop their skills to put material out and get discovered. These artists were picked up by corporations like Disney, who started hiring people to write the lyrics for two generations of what I call corporate pop stars. Every band and musician today, because they don't write their own lyrics and let the same corporate hirelings write for them, sounds the same. Third, as people nowadays seem to prefer the digital downloads to the real CDs, most record stores have gone belly up. And those that remain in business or brick and mortars that merely stock music stock modern pop and rap albums almost exclusively. And fourth, most artists today can't sing, so they tend to rely too heavily on auto-tune and other special effects in their shows and on their albums. So, here is an example of what I would recommend for those of you considering Blood on the Dance Floor to listen to instead. Here are Aerosmith, Janie's Got a Gun, Megadeth, Countdown to Extinction, and ZZ Top, Sharp Dressed Man. All three are examples of excellent musicianship. Disclaimer. Under the Fair Use Act of 1971, these are songs which I do not own the content of that are being used nonetheless for purposes of education as to what actual music is. That being said, here we go with Aerosmith's masterpiece, Janie's Got a Gun.
Yeah.
can go to the web folder, get out of the web folder on the computer screen. It's just this mistake.
You said you wouldn't be happy. This game is over. You were so bitter. I got instincts and how nothing works. Nobody else can take your dinner. Liars and haters, blaming makers who make it look way better. Even later, you'll be waiting for our invitation. Blank, blank, and you're so courageous. So courageous. Oh my God, nobody would. No reason left, no way to run.
Oh, that's it. That's the review. And you were just given three strong examples of what actual music is.
This is Cobra Officer 999 signing off. Thank you, and rock on till we meet again.